Hello, fans. I'm Brad Nessler alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup between the Louisville Cardinals and the Kentucky Wildcats. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
A great matchup at the off-guard position. I've been looking forward to this, Brad.
Tonight, we've got an intriguing matchup at the point guard position. Number four is the kind of leader a coach loves to have out on the floor.
On the other side, we've also got a great leader out on the floor. This will be a great matchup to track throughout the night.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action. See what's in store for us. For the tip. And after all the anticipation, we're underway. Gibbons handles the pass. And a momentary look from three-point land. Ten on the shot clock. Scores it. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Kicks it out. Ten on the shot clock. Tries for two. Too strong. Cross court. Puts up the jumper. Scorches the net with a J. Smith receives the pass. A little two-man action. For the bucket. They still don't score. The point guard gets the ball. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. They're lighting it up from the field right now, Dick.
They're in a dangerous rhythm, my friend.
Dangerous?
Dangerous for the defense if they keep it up.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. Up and in.
That's Matador defense. Nobody coming over. Nobody giving any help. I mean, that's how you see better defense on a playground.
Gave it up. Here comes the ball screen. For two. The layup. In the clear. Griffith has told his team, hey, get on my back, so to speak. He is carrying them right now.
He's getting it done out there, Brad. They'll be in trouble without him. He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking out of the box.
That's charging.
Caught him being selfish with the ball, Brad.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Now they get some additional instruction from their coach for this defensive possession. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Check out this highlight, courtesy of our friends at Pontiac. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. McCray receives the pass. Turnaround jumper. He gets the rebound.
Up and inside.
Spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing them to make that turn.
Oh, no. They should have come away with more than that.
That was horrible, Brad. They missed out on some points there.
On the dribble, gives it up. For the bucket. Perfectly executed. Looking for a good shot. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. He grabs the board. They look to get it to the inside. Goes up for two. Up and in. Both teams looking to get things going here.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. What's even more important, they'll have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Nice move with a face-up.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
Cross court. 10 seconds on the clock. For two. And off the mark. On the outside, takes away the pass. Tries for two. The layup. McCray receives the pass. Cross court.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Up and in. Five handles the feed. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Dick, you think they're going to stay this hot?
Hey, it doesn't look like they're slowing down, my friend. Look at that spacing.
The bucket, the layup. Gave it up. Goes up for two. Up and in. Working around the perimeter. The layup. The shooting guard takes the feed.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He takes the shot from the baseline. He couldn't get it to fall. For two. He's making just terrible choices shooting the ball.
He's got to settle down, man. Settle that cat down.
They work the perimeter. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, in regards to our player matchup, it's a matter of one guy focusing and taking advantage of shot opportunities. He seems to be making the most of it tonight.
Thanks, Aaron. That's, of course, Aaron Andrews, our correspondent on the sideline. Nice shot. The Wildcats have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Daddy's on fire.
Looking for a good shot. He attempts the trifecta. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. They'll work it around the arc. Tries for two. Up and in. The Cardinals will play up-tempo at one end and in the half court at the other end. Wouldn't you agree, Dick?
They feel they are more successful when they focus their attention on doing a bit of both, Brad. They have the personnel to be able to play up-tempo at one end and play in the half court at the other.
Gibbons handles the pass. On the outside. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Now they work it around the perimeter. Bucket. Perfectly executed. The Wildcats are definitely a slow it down type of team, Dick, and they're all about clock management and half court execution.
The moment they get away from this, they aren't as successful.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
10 seconds on the shot clock. Moving it around the perimeter. Turnaround jumper with the board.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
The power forward with the ball. Goes up for two. The layup. Working it around the perimeter. I think the coach is going to have to make some changes here, Dick. The players are starting to look really tired out there.
10 on the shot clock.
Dump it inside.
Goes for the deep one. He gets the bucket to fall. Smith receives the pass. For two, the layup. He draws a foul. McCray coming in for the first time tonight.
He will give his defense a different kind of threat at this position. Smart move.
Trying to pack it inside. 2-for-1 opportunity. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Man on the shot clock. Baseline jumper. And nice looking jumper in the lane. And a momentary look from three-point land. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. He launches a three. Off target. At the half, the Cardinals are trailing by two. Now let's rewind a little bit here and watch the play of the half. Folks, we're halfway through the contest. Dick, what do you see with the points of emphasis so far?
I think these guys were mentally and physically ready to play today. They're doing everything I brought up earlier in regards to the points of emphasis.
Well put, and we'll see how these teams do in the second half. Kentucky shot lights out from the floor in the first half.
I tell you, they executed exactly the way the coaching staff envisioned in their game plan. Huge credit goes to the players for making it happen on the floor.
Dick, in the second half, our player matchup update, and they're playing very, very even right now. They're not making mistakes.
I tell you what, not making mistakes, and both are doing a great job getting to the free throw line. I think that's been essential in their converting on the line.
Get out of the way, baby. That was absolutely sensational.
Lee handles the pass. Kicks it out. Ten on the shot clock. He puts up the J. The missed shot. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
The Wildcats struggled in the first half because of their reluctance to use the shot clock. Dick, earlier you identified this as an important point and something they had to do in order to be successful. Well, they're not doing it now and have fallen behind. Brad?
All right, thanks, Erin. The shooting guard receives the ball. Inside. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. And now there's a whistle and a foul. We're talking about half-court teams, Dick. What types of players do you expect to be on that type of roster?
I think you need players who really understand the game and know how to get others open, as well as use screens. Typically, they aren't the most athletic guys.
Lee receives the pass.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He grabs the rebound. Handles the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Turnaround jumper. Gets the board.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
Cross court. Bucket, perfectly executed. He shoots the jumper. A lot of people can't hit that shot anymore, Dick, that 10-12 foot shot.
Yeah, the medium range shot is an extension.
Gave it up. Ten seconds to put up a shot. He missed. Griffith receives the pass. Takes the jumper. The Cardinals have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
As we continue to track the game's tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Seconds showing on the shot clock. For two, up and in. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
A snail's pace, Brad. That's the tempo of this game. But if that's your philosophy, so be it.
Phillips receives the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. 10 seconds to put up a shot. Tries for two. The Wildcats have got to continue to get him the ball.
Daddy's on fire.
Gave it up. On the shot clock. They get that rejected. Can't get the shot to drop. Lee receives the ball. A little two-man action. Gibbons receives the pass. Goes up for two. The lay-in. The dribble, gives it up. For two. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Call this a one-man show, Brad. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
Looking for a good shot. And he'll kick it back outside. Jumper, bust the jumper. Smith receives the ball. The Wildcats have a number of seniors in their lineup. That factor alone will definitely help their cause. Smith handles the pass. 10 seconds to put it up. Smith is feeling it right now.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Number 53 takes the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Ten on the shot clock. Tries for two. Up and in. Check out the replay, Dick. Definitely worth being part of our Pontiac game-changing performance.
Talk about highlight material, Mr. Nestler. That's a strong candidate for our Pontiac game-changing performance.
Dumps it in. Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
In and out. Gibbons receives the ball. On the outside. Let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, the player matchup has been our focus tonight, and he's been effective because his teammates are finding him in the right spots, and he's knocking down all his shots, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. EA, of course, our third member, getting that additional insight and dealings from the sideline. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The Wildcats. Coaching staff is starting to make it quite clear that they want the pace of this game to stay where it's at. He recently commended his players for playing at a slow tempo, which suits their team well. They claim to be successful when they play in this manner, so expect for it to continue.
Aaron Andrews, our sideline correspondent, as usual, providing that extra bit of insight. For the bucket. He hits a bullseye again.
Hey, he's feeling it from everywhere, baby.
Lee handles the feed. Inside. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
10 on the shot clock. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is. Basic.
Well, partner, this one could go right down to the wire.
You've got to love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
Now trying to feed the low block. 10 on the shot clock.
Great composure to pass it despite the trap.
He's money with a shot. He looks for three. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
Obvious foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
Gave it up. Was that beautiful or what? The Wildcats are a half-court team, Dick. What do they and other half-court teams try to do when they step out there on the court?
Half-court teams really will rely on each other. They'll not get any easy baskets, so they basically got to execute offensively by really moving the basketball and setting some good screens.
They work it around the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Strong rebound, and now looking to move it down court in a hurry.
They need to get out and run their lanes now. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He shoots the jumper. He knocks down the jumper. They work the perimeter. For the deuce, the lane. Looking for a good shot. For two, up for the lay-in. It's a one-point game.
1 point usually means free throws, Brad.
Lee handles the feed. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a close player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The Wildcats. Coaching staff is comfortable with the current pacing of this game. They feel that the total number of possessions have to be kept to a minimum. This means extended offensive possessions and tough defense. If they can sustain this style of play, the chances of them winning is more likely. Guys?
Our trusty sideline reporter, Aaron Andrews, keeping everyone on their toes there on the sideline. He seems determined to take the tough shot.
And they're not falling, and the offense is being totally taken out of sync.
Cross court. He pulls up with a jumper. He misses the J. They'll work it around the arc. Open for the shot. The Cardinals have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Daddy's on fire.
The point guard with the ball. On the outside. He takes the open jumper. It's good. We got a timeout on the floor, and with that, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
As you guys know, free throw shooting becomes very important down the stretch. The coaching staff is aware of this, and we'll be talking about this in the timeout. It'll be up to the players to knock them down.
Timeouts are a great opportunity for coaches to organize their team and talk some strategy. But what types of things do you think they're discussing of this?
It's tough to say, but I can guarantee that the coaches want their respective teams to be on the same page. Once the timeout is over, nothing is worse than being disorganized or turning the ball over immediately following a timeout.
He got it for the win. Unbelievable, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing. They're dancing with joy. Is he going to be the BMOC? Big man on campus. He wanted the rock, Brad. Oh, they're celebrating. It's going to be a wild time on the campus tonight.
Final thoughts, Dick. What are they?
These points of emphasis are a great guide for a team. Whether you're an up-tempo, half-court, or somewhere in between, you must do the things which will make you successful.
One skill which is often overlooked is the ability to play to your strengths and not to your weaknesses. It's a must to play your style of play and to do the things that make your team successful. Dick, we can talk about matchups all we want, but really it's not just always a one-on-one matchup. There's a lot of guys out there contributing.
Yeah, there really are. You got to play as a unit. It's all about the team. That's what gets you to the winner's circle.
K
Kentucky loses a nail-biter.
It's always tough to lose to a team that you know you can beat.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.